Hi there, I'm Jorge, and I'm a developer evangelist for Oracle. In this video, we're going to talk about running containers on your Mac system. By the end of the video, you will learn how to run containers on both Apple Silicon and Intel-based Mac systems. You will learn how to run AMD 64 and ARM 64-based containers in your Apple Silicon Mac, and you will also learn how to run containers for the Oracle Database 23 AI Free Image Container and the Oracle Autonomous Database Free Image Container. So you can try them, develop with them, learn about their features, and so on. Hope you like it. Let's go with it. Okay, so let's introduce some concepts before we start running the containers. But if you know anything that you need to know about containers, or you just don't care about it, and you just want to run your containers using Colima, you can jump to this time spot in the video and we will be doing that, running the containers. If you have stayed, then I assume that you want to discuss a little bit more about containers, and a container is just a way of running an application in a constrained environment. They can be very, very helpful. They help us with isolating the application from the rest of the world and choosing what we want to share with it. They can also restrict the amount of resources used by the application. So we can say this amount of memory or this amount of CPU and not more than that. We can also be sure that everything that we need in order to run a container is inside of it. That's very helpful because all the dependencies must be in the container. They are self-contained applications. We also benefit from this self-contained and the way they get installed, because then we won't be littering our disk with applications that we want to try once or that use once in a while. We can run them, get rid of the image, and everything will go with it. Finally, they are very helpful for the situation in which your application is running for your system, but not in somebody else's. So it runs on my machine, that's the model that they are trying to avoid here, is something that is gone when you're using containers, because your container is the same one that is going to run in somebody else's system. In principle, you could run containers on any operating system. And the truth is that some of the features that are needed in order to run containers are not available in every operating system. In order to run containers in Linux, we use something that is called namespaces, and they help us with this isolation and control of the resources. But we don't have namespaces under macOS. Instead, we have something that is called app sandboxing. And it's a similar technology, but it is more aimed at limiting access to certain parts of the hard disk and also restricting the access that you have to the data, like the contacts, or also to some parts of the hardware, like the USB that gets connected or the network. So, running containers natively in a macOS system would be a little bit hard. We should be doing it in a different way. Let's talk about that. What we can do instead of using containers right on top of macOS is run a virtual machine. A virtual machine is a way of isolating processes by splitting the resources of our system and having a full operating system running in each virtual machine. That is a lot of overhead when you want to run several of them, and it adds up very fast. And that's because the amount of resources required mean that at the very least you should have enough to run the operating system of each of the virtual machines. But we can do something in the middle. We can create a virtual machine that runs Linux and use that very restricted, very limited, small instance of Linux that provides us with the namespaces in order to run containers on top of it. Then we would be benefiting from the best of both worlds. We would have a virtual machine that has some restriction but offers us the capabilities of the Linux system, and then we will be running containers on top of it. There are many things that we can do with containers running in a virtual machine, but still there are some limitations. A virtual machine reproduces the hardware that it is based on. So if you're running a virtual machine in an Intel x86-64 or AMD-64, however you want to call it, the system that will run on top of it is going to be also an Intel-based system. And same happens the other way around. If you have an Apple Silicon Mac, the virtual machine that you will have is going to be for an ARM64 architecture. And since most of the containers are available for AMD64, and not so many for ARM, there is a limitation that we should overcome somehow. And the way of doing that is by using an emulator. An emulator is a piece of software that is able to translate from one architecture to another. You will be able to run software that is meant for the AMD64 for Intel into an ARM64 platform. Colima, containers on Lima, uses Lima Linux machines to run a virtualized environment in your system. And it supports two different technologies for virtualization. One is called VC or VZ, depending on your side of the pond, and it is a virtualization framework that is available inside of macOS since macOS 11. But if you want to use Lima, you need to have version 13.5 or later in order to run these virtual machines with Lima. The other one, the other virtualization, is QEMU. And QEMU is a whole emulator that emulates the whole machine and runs a virtual machine for another architecture. So what it is doing is running a virtual machine, but for AMD64 rather than the native one. Still, that has to emulate the whole environment, and that is expensive in terms of resources. There's another option, and it comes built in your macOS system, and that is Rosetta. Rosetta is another emulator that translates the binary and runs AMD64 binaries on your ARM64 platform. The main difference between QEMU and Rosetta is that QEMU is meant for the whole virtual machine, while Rosetta is only at the process level. So it is, in general terms, faster for what we are trying to do here. Since we have talked about isolation, it is good to mention how to share information between your system and your containers and virtual machine. If you're running the VC virtualization framework, then your preferred option should be to use Virtio.fs, which is like the native one and is going to be your fastest option. But if you use QEMU, there are two options. One is 9P and the other one is SSH.fs. 9P is more reliable but slower, while SSH.fs is faster, but it doesn't deal very well with a lot of concurrent reads and writes. So your choice, since we are going to go with VC in this video, Virtio.fs is our option. If you have an Intel-based Mac, then you will be using the VC virtualization framework in order to run the virtual machine, and you will be running the containers on top of it. This is going to be a very strong solution because most of the containers are available for AMD64, which is the Intel architecture, and you shouldn't have any problem with that. However, if you're running an Apple Silicon Mac, as I do, Then you can go with the VC virtualization framework and run your virtual machine in ARM64 architecture. And then you will be using Rosetta to run the containers. That, together with VirtuFS, is going to be the fastest option, and you will be able to run both containers that are meant for ARM64 natively and containers that are meant for AMD64 by using the Rosetta binary. Now it's time to install Colima. And before we install the different packages required to run Colima, we will run Rosetta, that is part of the macOS operating system. It will ask us to agree with the SLA, and it will download it and install it. So far so good, no problem there. Even though there's this message, you shouldn't worry about that. The next thing is installing the different packages, and for that we are going to use a brew. And we will be installing Colima, that is the containers on Lima, then the Docker runtime and Docker Compose for running several containers at the same time. So that should work for us. I have already installed all these packages and they are up to date. With Colima installed, you can start it. And started it means that you are going to specify the virtualization type. In this case, I'm using VC, the virtualization framework that is available in macOS. Then I'm using also Rosetta, I mean enabling it, and I ask Colima to use VirtuFS as the file system mount to share data between the containers and the main system. The same goes for the specification of the virtual machine, so I'm asking for 4 virtual CPUs and 8 gigabytes of RAM that are going to be dedicated to the virtual machine. You could also initialize this without having all the parameters in the command line, but editing the file. But if you do that, please double check that all the parameters that we have up there are included in the configuration file. So I'm not going to do that because it is already started. Instead, what I'm going to do is to query the status. So if I do Colima status, I get the architecture that is being used to run the virtual machine, which is ARM. And that is using the virtualization framework, the runtime is Docker, and the mount type is VirtuFS. So exactly what I ask, and that should be fine. The other thing that you can do when you don't need Colima anymore is to stop it. And that is as easy as stopping Colima with the stop command. And once you have decided that you don't need Colima installed in your machine, or that you want to change the shape or the properties of the virtual machine, you can delete it and restart the process again. I'm going to do that just to show you that you need to confirm twice, and it will delete everything regarding the configuration of Colima. I have restarted the Colima virtual machine, and I'm going to verify the status to see that it's up and running, and we get the same information as we did before. So we are going to launch the Oracle Database 23AI frequent image container, and we are going to use this command to launch it. And it takes no time because I have already pulled it. Notice that I'm using the platform Linux ARM64, so it is running natively here, and it uses this information for the container, the latest version. You can go with a given one. I'm choosing the password I'm going to use later, and this is the port that is exposing to the outside world. I can use Docker PS to check that the container is up and running, and I can even go and use the Docker logs to see that the database is ready to use. This is a very fast container, so it takes no time to have the database up and running, and now you can use it to do whatever you like.
The Oracle Autonomous Database 23 AI Free Image Container is currently only available for AMD 64 architecture, that is Intel. And we're using here an Apple Silicon-based Mac, so we want to run that container, that is for a different architecture, in this Mac. So the first thing that I'm going to do is to download the image. I have already pre-downloaded, so it doesn't take any time. But in your case, it will take some time to download the image from the repository. I could have used the platform flag in order to say that I want an ARM image, but it says that it was found, but the platform is not the one that you asked me. It is AMD 64. So we will have to live with that. The way we have to use this container is very similar to the database 23AI1 that we have used previously. It has more options for the ports, and you can look at the documentation in the container registry. But what I'm doing here is opening the ports for MongoDB API and for other stuff here, and I'm using this name ADB free rather than DB free that I was using before. I could be very clear here and specify the platform. I could go to the beginning of the line and here say platform, Linux ARM 64, AMD 64. And then I won't get a warning message. It would be launched directly and I will have the container up and running. I can do as I did before with Docker PS and see that the container is running. And I can also go and check the logs, in this case for ADB free, which is the one that I have launched here. Once we have the information about the listener up here, the Oracle Autonomous Database 23 AI is ready to be used. That's it. Enjoy it.
So in this video, we have talked about different technologies to run what we need in our Mac system. We have talked about containers, virtual machines, and emulators, and how to combine them to run the containers that we need in our Apple Silicon-based Mac system. We have also run the Oracle Database 23 AI Free Image Container and the Oracle Autonomous Database Free Image Container. And with that, we are able to do a lot of things. Try the features, develop with them, learn about the database, and many others. I hope that this has been useful to you. And if so, please like the video and subscribe to this channel because there will be plenty more. Till then, stay curious. Hack your code. See you next time.